He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
So far in our investigation of Spiralia, we have covered the phyla Platyhelminthes and Gastrotrica. Let's now move on to their close relatives in Phylum Cycliophora. The fascinating creatures which inhabit this clade were first discovered only very recently in 1995 by Dr. Peter Funch, who has graciously assisted in the writing of this tutorial, as well as Dr. Reinhard Mobjerg Christensen, whose assistance we will enjoy when we cover the phylum Micronathozoa a bit later in the series. Now, we've covered some strange animals so far, but the microscopic sac-like cycliophorans, also known as symbions or ring-bearers, just might be the strangest. They, like the flatworms and gastrotrichs, are bilaterally symmetrical, meaning they can be split into left and right halves, which are rough mirror images. They are triploblastic, meaning they have three unique germ cell layers. They are unsegmented, meaning they do not demonstrate metamerism. They are generally non-colonial, meaning they do not form interconnected colonies, though their unique feeding stage with a developing buccal funnel inside can be regarded as two individuals. And they are acoelomates, meaning they do not have a body cavity and lack respiratory organs. The fluid inside their brood chambers is circulated by cilia. They comprise a phylum of incredibly tiny animals that measure less than half a millimeter wide at their largest, and live their lives attached to the mouthparts of cold water lobsters in the North Atlantic Ocean and the Mediterranean Sea. They are considered to have a commensalist relationship with their lobster hosts, since they feed by driving uneaten food particles from the lobster into their digestive systems through ciliary action. They do not appear to harm the host lobster in any way. Cycliophorans are deeply connected to their host. Their unique life cycle is due in part to the fact that they live primarily upon the cuticle attached to the setae, or the bristle-like extensions of an animal that continually molts. They have six basic life stages: the asexual feeding stage, the sexual male stage, the sexual female stage, the Pandora stage, the Prometheus larva, and the chordoid larva. Let's follow the life journey of a single cycliophoran, starting with a settled larva. This larva will develop into a feeding individual with an inner bud. At this point, a few different things can happen. First, let's follow the asexual stage. A small organism known as a Pandora larva can escape from the feeding individual and colonize the same lobster host. These larvae are produced in the intermolt period of the host. In this way, the Pandora larva can colonize the same lobster. This larva will then settle and develop back into a feeding stage. A feeding stage individual can potentially develop to hold a male larva released as a Prometheus larva that settles onto another feeding individual. The settled juvenile male will then further develop 1 to 3 sexually mature males inside its own body, each of which is only about 1/3 of its size, meaning the sexually mature males are smaller than the juvenile males and are one of the smallest known animals in the world. Meanwhile, other feeding stages develop to hold developing females. Each female contains a single oocyte. Once fertilized, the pregnant female escapes and settles into a sheltered area of the same host. It then encysts and produces a single motile chordoid larva that hatches from the cyst and settles onto a new host, where it develops into a feeding stage and initiates its asexual cycle. Due to their unique life cycle and cryptic nature, the exact phylogeny of the cycliophorans has been debated for quite some time. Proposed homologies have placed the cycliophorans as cousins to Rotifera, kin to Bryozoans, and closely related to Entoprocta. Though they have been accepted as members of Spiralia, it is possible their precise placement may change in the future. Regardless of where they end up, their relatively recent discovery and their abundance on species of lobster widely consumed by humans means there is likely much more to learn about them, and potentially many other species of cycliophorans waiting to be discovered. That covers the symbionts, so let's move forward and look at some other phyla.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.